Sunday liquor sales.
The bill now back in motion in Hartford. Does it have a chance this time? Our chief capital correspondent Mark Davis is live in our Hartford newsroom with a look at the odds. Mark?
Hi, Sonia and Darren. Good evening, everyone, from the Hartford newsroom. Yes, the odds appear quite good this year because there's been a lot of change at the state capitol and a very, very big change at the top.
The annual debate about allowing liquor stores to stay open on Sunday seems to already have a renewed push. State Rep. Kathy Tallarita represents the Massachusetts border town of Enfield.
Representing a border town, seeing cars literally flying over those lines to Massachusetts for not only their alcohol, but their gasoline and other things.
And she says New York and Rhode Island border reps say the same thing. But the head of the 1,100-member Connecticut Package Store Association says it'll just spread the same amount of sales over 7 days. And staying open the extra day will cost these small businesses $12,000 to $14,000 a year.
It's the formula for losing jobs. And I'll lose probably 350 stores, and then we lose the drivers and the wholesalers who used to call on them. We lose the salesmen that call on them, and pretty soon we got another whole open storefront on Main Street.
We are not trying to force anyone to do anything they don't want to do. If you still want to stay closed on Sunday, you're more than welcome to. If you want to stay open on Sunday and close on Monday, go ahead and do it. I'm not saying everyone has to do this.
But here's the big reason it could finally pass.
Sunday liquor sales, do you think that's a good idea?
I've been very clear in my position. If the legislature passes it, I'm signing it. So it's not an issue that I'm playing a lead role on, but if the legislature passes it, then I'll sign it.
The argument that it might put somebody's mom and pops out of business?
I'm not going to get involved in the argument. If the legislature passes it, I'm going to sign it.
He's not going to get involved with the argument. If they pass it, he'll sign it. Is that quite clear? I think it's very clear. With the governor saying this to me, and in a very, very public way, the proponents feel that'll make a very big difference. A big public hearing on this issue is probably going to be held sometime at the state capitol within the next few weeks. Live from the Hartford newsroom, Mark Davis, News 8.